Welcome in, everybody. It's the coach. This is Madden 20 on EA Sports. On tap is what should be a pretty good matchup between the Washington Redskins and the Minnesota Vikings. With that, we send you up to U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. Standing by our commentators, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And we find ourselves at the stadium that played host to Super Bowl 52, the wondrous U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. It can certainly get loud inside this building. And just a few moments ago when the Vikings were introduced, it was downright shaking in here. They're set for football as the Vikings get ready to do battle with the Washington Redskins. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gunn, and Charles, kickoff moments away. Quickly, what are you watching in this one?
The offensive line for both teams, because both teams have a terrific pass rush. They've got to keep their passers upright. If they have a chance to do that, they can both thrive on offense and move the ball downfield.
Dan Bailey now to put the ball in the air, and we are underway from downtown Minneapolis. Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So out comes the Redskins offense now onto the field. They are led out by the 15th overall selection in 2019, former Ohio State Buckeye Dwayne Haskins. Haskins got a man. That's Quinn. A good safe pass there right off the bat.
That's almost a rhythm play. That's what we like to call it. Get them into rhythm early, something safe, something they're confident about, something they feel good. And once that's completed, then you just keep moving from there because the confidence elevates.
Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. Here we go. The first carry for the former Viking, Peterson. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll leave them with a third and three. Here's the offense, and when you talk about this offense, you certainly have to talk about all day AP, Adrian Peterson.
Does not shy away from contact, also has the speed to go the distance. It's the rare combination that you get from one of the great runners of all time in the NFL. 2,000 yards every year is the goal. I never bet against him.
Third play of this opening drive as they're looking at a third and three. A first carry now for Thompson. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important third down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. A give to Peterson out of the gun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. And a look at the Vikings defensive unit.
Harrison Smith is a player I love to watch. Whether he's ranging deep as a free safety or near the line of scrimmage where he makes more plays, keep your eyes on him.
To Haskins to throw it. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Danielle Hunter. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
An extra defender in the secondary for the Vikings here on third down. Now Haskins, third and long. And he's going to go down again. Everson Griffin providing a little deja vu, back-to-back sacks, and now they're staring at a fourth and long. Well, they went with a nickel. They throw in an extra defensive back. Coverage was very good.
Yeah, it was exactly as you would expect. A passing down, you bring in the nickel package. Just as you described, the coverage was excellent and allowed one of their linemen to end up getting to the quarterback.
So on fourth down, the Redskins will call on Tressway to punt it away. Marcus Sherrill's back deep for Minnesota. This is taken at the 15. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Vikings will take over here first and 10. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. They'll be led out by the veteran quarterback out of Michigan State. The former Spartan, it's Kirk Cousins.
Forget the measurables. His temperament, which is so even-keeled, often masks a burning desire to win and perform. This guy takes it seriously when he lines up to play, and usually he puts on a nice performance.
Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A little jet sweep to start the drive. Space to maneuver at the 40. And all the way up to the 46. Now whistles and a timeout. Looks like we've got a Viking slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10.
Let's go. Under 10. Under 10.
Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he's got it across the midfield stripe and into Washington territory. The tackle there by Fabian Moreau. And the offensive starters for the Vikings.
For a lot of people, there are pros and cons to playing close to home in the NFL. But for Adam Thielen, it's nothing but pros. Grew up not too far from the Twin Cities, loves being a Viking, and is a really dependable third down receiver.
Coming to you.
From just shy of midfield, Cousins. This one taken in by Olabisi Johnson. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
Mike, number 53.
First down, here's the run with Cook. The tackle by Cole Holcomb. And now a look at the Washington defense.
Landon Collins is built like your typical tackle first safety, but he does have the ability to play the deep part of the field.
Second down, Cook, and an alley to run. But he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash 6 yards on the play. You were telling me this yesterday. This is exactly what they want to do on the opening drive, establish the ground game.
Yeah, remember our conversation. We were talking about what one of the GMs in the league has told me repeatedly. It's a big man's game, and it's not necessarily size. He's talking about playing some big boy football. Line up, get leverage, knock people back, and establish the run early.
Now Cousins. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two. That's going to go as a loss of one on first down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for loss yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and caused a nice play for loss yardage.
Back at the two now, here's second and goal.
Get that quarterback, D-line! Get that quarterback, D-line!
Throwing his Cousins. Rush coming, and he's taken down.
Back him up, back him up!
When you're this close to the goal line, you got to expect pressure from the defense, so the ball's got to come out fast. Got to get out of his hands quicker.
They need to reverse the trend. The last two plays have gone backwards. Now it's third and goal. Working out of the gun, Cousins. It's complete. Abdullah. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. They wind up with 6 on the hook up there, but it's not enough. Fourth and goal.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
So Cousins heads to the Vikings sideline, and on is Dan Bailey to try the field goal. From the left hash, a chip shot here. And Bailey able to knock it through. And the Vikings have a 3-0 lead. Well, after marching down the field, only getting 3 there, kind of feels like a win for the defense.
And it does. They'll go to the sideline feeling a lot better that they didn't give up a touchdown after the march against them. But if I were the offense, I wouldn't hang my head over that one. That's a good drive, and 3 points were put on the board.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. At the 2. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 27. Here's Peterson as they begin on the ground. And he powers his way up past the 30. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
Darius Geis, his first carry of the game. And oh, his first carry. He loses the football. And then pass belongs to the Vikings. Well, he's not the starter coming in, getting his first carry off the bench. That's not the way to earn more carries.
You have to stay in the game, even if you're not on the field, right? Stay mentally sharp, stay ready. And above all, when you get into the game, hold on to the football. Don't let the other team have it.
Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start first and 10. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Let's go, defense. Let's go, defense. And here we go.
Cousins gives way to Cook. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. Getting the sense, Charles, they're going to put a big emphasis this afternoon on the run game.
And why not? What we're seeing so far, it's working pretty well from them. And here's the best part. We always talk about the best performers do their job when the lights come on. I think he likes natural light best.
Now Cousins here on the bootleg. Johnson's got it complete. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Yeah, he's got it, and he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Nice job defensively to hold him to 4, and now it's second and goal.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Throwing again on second down. Cousins, and this is caught. For the moment, it's a touchdown, but multiple flags down, so let's sort this out. So reverse the celebration. We'll see if they have something else in their bag of tricks.
And isn't that always tough to watch when they score and you see the excitement, and then when they realize those points aren't going to count? Can they get it back together and find their way back to the end zone?
They've been denied touchdowns in the red zone twice already. Here comes third and goal. They'll run for it with Cook. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Minnesota. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Dan Bailey now for the extra point. And oh, it's blocked. That's a live ball scooped up by the offense.
We gonna shut y'all down.
Yeah. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field.
And this is a unit that, to be frank, doesn't look like they've woken up yet. I mean, a punt and a turnover on their first two drives.
And I think the game's starting to take shape a little bit now. And I'm going to take it into the basketball world. When you're having trouble scoring or moving the ball in basketball, what do? Get it to their best player, right? Find a matchup, create it, exploit it, and try and move the football.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 26. Four yards on the dump off at second down. Second down now. It's Thompson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down.
Well, how many times do we say in this game is speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice gain.
Haskins on first down. Connects here with a tight end, Jeremy Sprinkle. Yeah, he's got this to the 30 before being taken down. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. And that's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
From Viking territory now, they'll come up first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Shotgun handoff to Thompson. Now the ball comes loose, and the Vikings pick up the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Whenever I see a team turn it over on back-to-back drives, fumbles on their last two, I know one person's blood pressure who is starting to rise, and that's the head coach.
Absolutely. And when's it going to go down? When they stop fumbling?
When they stop fumbling and after he's assessed the game film, and only if they manage to win the game.
And now out comes Minnesota. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 15. Cousins now after the fumble recovery. And he's taken down. Back at his own 7. Montez Sweat just would not be denied. That's a loss of 7.
Now we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. One start right field for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
Don't need it all back at once, but you figure they're going to need something here. 17 yards to go on second down. And the catch made by Johnson. And he'll lose yardage and be down at the 7-yard line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackled behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
The Redskins on third down, putting an extra man here in the secondary. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. And this is Cook with a grab. It'll be a two-yard gain, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. That's taken at around the 40. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Redskins football now with a first and 10. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And last time, the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of what was frustrating. Down on the scoreboard, had a drive going, had pushed it past the 50-yard line, so they felt like they were in striking distance, and to come away with nothing, not a good feeling at all, to put it mildly. Now they can't afford to do that again.
Yeah, now can they get that bad taste out of their mouth here? They start on the ground with Geis. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
Now a quick pass to Richardson. And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down.
That was impressive to me because while it was a pass play, they still rallied to the football like they were filling running lanes, and they were able to put the receiver on the ground.
So third and 2, this quite possibly four down territory, though, if they're stopped. They'll run it. Here's Peterson. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. The defense stiffens to force fourth down following that first down gain of 8.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. And this will carry out of bounds. Where are they going to spot it now? At about the 18-yard line, it looks like. Now the Minnesota offense set to take over again. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their own 18.
All day, baby, all day. Where's the hot hot?
Cousins now. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And he'll be corralled well upfield right around the 40-yard line. A good pickup there, a 22.
The beauty of route running is it doesn't matter what position, everyone's doing the same thing. In this case, tight end selling the vertical route. Get the defensive back on his heels, break off for the corner, and with good timing, you get a completion as we just saw there.
So quickly, all the way up at the 40-yard line.
Watch a slant, watch a slant, watch a slant.
On the jet sweep, this is Johnson. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Anytime the offense shows what they call a shot play or a chunk play where they're trying to get big yardage, sometimes people just call it gadget plays, and you hold it to a gain that we just saw there, you feel pretty good about yourself as a defense.
Check 53's mine. And watch delay. Check, 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 check.
On second down, it's Cook. And he'll get it into enemy territory just across midfield at the 49. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
And Brandon, you know that expression? He just does what he does. It sounds trite, doesn't it? But in this case, it's perfectly apt. This is one of the better runners in the NFL. And all he does is just find avenues, find ways to pick up key first downs and big runs.
They run again on first down. Cook. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
On second down now, it's Cook. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. Well, they're making a real first quarter statement with a run game, no doubt.
For those who remember old school football, running it, establishing things, seeing backs find holes, get through them, they've got to like what they're seeing from this unit so far. Right now, they've decided to, as you've said, establish the run game, and they've been successful doing it.
Following the good run by Cook, here's another first and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
All right, Brad, I know we're in the early going here, but those kind of runs, they're going to open up a world of opportunities for this offense going forward.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. After one, it's 9-0. Vikings on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. From the gun, here's Cousins. That'll be complete to Cook. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first.
He wasn't ready. He wasn't ready. So
out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this one from 48 yards away. And his kick is good. Not by much. It was leaking oil in the end, but he tucks it in the bottom right corner. And that will bump up the lead again to 12-0. No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
Now after the field goal, Bailey will kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now.
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Haskins and the Redskins come up 1st and 10 at their own 27. Throwing now, Haskins on 1st down. That's complete. Terry McLaurin with it. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
That one, a first down pickup of eight. Haskins and the offense with a first and 10. And he's a perfect 5 for 5 here to begin the game. Now Thompson. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Okay, he didn't break that one all the way, but you got to know that he feels like he's right on the verge. And that's probably exactly what he's telling them in the huddle right now.
Three receivers head out right, one to the left on 2nd and 3.
Right there, 54, right there, right there. 54.
Second down, Haskins. This one complete to Calvin Harmon. And he'll be brought down at the 48-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another 1st and 10. They run the counter now. It's Peterson. Yeah, boy, this defense again really making things tough on him as they stop him for no gain. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
And this is going to turn into another 1st down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 37.
They sure put the coverage guys in a stress on that one. They thought they were going deep. Ends up curling inside for a nice chunk of yardage.
Haskins and the offense with a 1st and 10. And he's 4 for 4 now, throwing the ball to start the drive. On 1st and 10, it's Haskins. That's going to be caught by Richardson. They'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6. A gain of 6 there on 1st. Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. Back to the ground, Peterson. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what'll be a 3rd and 4. Nice job there defensively to clamp down because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back at them.
Got a man out of the backfield. It's Chris Thompson.
We play to win.
A pickup of 5 that time and a 1st down.
And that's understanding where the markers are because it's not just running to them. Because on the catch, you could actually be pushed back before the 1st down. It's getting past it and allowing that opportunity to drift back towards the 1st down line and still having picked it up. Really well run.
Haskins and the offense with a 1st and 10. And he's hit on his 1st 9 passes now in the ball game. On the carry, Thompson. And he'll be dropped at the 23 after a pickup of about 4.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short gain.
On 2nd down, it's Thompson. Just a 1-yard pickup there, and it's going to make it 3rd down at 6.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. The Redskins on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6. Third down. Here's Haskins. Complete. Richardson has it. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a 1st and goal. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. Out of the shotgun, Haskins. This is caught. 3 yards is the gain that time. 2nd and goal. They come out here in the eye.
Check, walk 54. Let's go, deep, tighten up.
On the ground, Geis, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Darius Geis taking it in as they are now on the board here in the first half.
I know we don't talk about it enough, but the intelligence level of the guys up front blocking, the offensive linemen, maybe the smartest guys in football overall. Add in a little bit of athleticism and a whole lot of toughness, you've got a lot to deal with, don't you?
That's why the guys in the backfield get them really nice Christmas gifts, right?
If they're smart, they do.
Dustin Hopkins on now to add the extra point. And this is back to a 5-point game. That one was an extended drive, 14 plays all told. And it's capped off by a Darius Geis touchdown run. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And he'll be stopped just shy of the 25 with a penalty marker down. Here's the call.
Face mask. Defense.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward.
Automatic 1st down.
Minnesota offense about ready to get this next drive underway. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for 3 except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time it's end zone and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get 3, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
Mike.
Jahan, Mike.
Mike. Hey, pick your game up. Watch the safety creep.
Now Cook. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
What's the old expression? 3 yards in a cloud of dust? In this case, it's dust-covered pellets. It's no longer that old grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
You got nothing
in there.
On 2nd down now, it's Cook. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of 1, and it'll be 3rd down.
But with the kind of half he's had, I think we can forgive him that run, right? Not every run's going to be a big play, is it?
No, and also the blocking just wasn't there. No room to run.
Yeah, defensively, they got to find a way to build on that because he's eating them alive in the first half.
The Vikings on third down. They've only converted once in four tries. This is third and nine. Throwing, Cousins. And that will be incomplete.
They went with the dime look that time on defense, just flooded the field backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he's on to punt for Minnesota. And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Adrian Peterson now getting ready to go again on offense. He's just been looking for some space. Yeah, I'm not going to pin it on him or the offensive line, but they need to get this run game going better.
Sometimes you just have to credit the defense. They came in with a plan themselves. So I think now you try and mix things up a little bit. Get the ball in the hands of some other people, find some other playmakers, but always let the defense believe that he's still a threat.
I was going to say, don't forget about it.
No, don't take him totally out of the game.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. Now it's Haskins looking for McLaurin, and he's got him. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. It's a first down for the Redskins on a pickup of 11.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Let's go. Haskins looking to throw on first down. Got a man, that's Quinn. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Looking to throw again on second down. Haskins over the middle, complete. That's Richardson. And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 42.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route, and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and get the quarterback a really nice target.
Haskins able to connect there with Richardson. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
4 yards on that last completion. So that sets up second and 6. Again, it's Haskins. And that's incomplete. He was trying to get it there to Vernon Davis, the tight end. And now it's third down. And that right there, his first incompletion of the game, pretty remarkable.
So let's start talking about all-time records, because with that incompletion, maybe over a 2-game sequence, or maybe starts a new streak now, because Ryan Tannehill, over 2 games, hit 25 straight. Now, the incompletion, we're taking this record out of play. But Mark Brunell, when he's with Washington, 22 straight completions to start a game. This guy's on fire.
And this is going to turn into another first down as the tackle is made at the Vikings 28.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
Yeah, they were right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up.
Come on,
Haskins and the offense with a first and 10. And he's 5 for 6 now throwing the ball on this drive. Now it's AP, Adrian Peterson. On the tackle, it's Trey Waynes.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. From the 25 on second down, Haskins. That's complete to his receiver, McLaurin. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't they?
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, you know, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Third down, it's Adrian Peterson. And he's going to have a first down here as he gets this one to the 17-yard line. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
I haven't met a football team yet that runs the ball successfully that doesn't talk about having an attitude to be a running football team, right? You got to be able to put your nose in there, smell where the first down sticks are, and get there.
They run again on first down, Peterson. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. Well, if you look where that play starts, O-line versus D-line, that was a battle won by the D-line.
Yeah, and oftentimes it's won by quickness off the ball. Who can handle the guy across from them best? On that play, the defensive line did exactly that.
Here's a throw out wide to Quinn. And they'll lose yardage here. Knocked back to the 19-yard line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. And never good on a pass completion there to go the wrong way. Lost yardage.
No, for some reason it seems to work better when you throw it downfield or you can move the ball downfield running it that way, doesn't it? But in this case, if you're the defensive guys, you're energized, executed well, and you caused a lost yardage play. That's going to feel good and look great in film.
This offense, 2 for 2 on third downs on this drive. They're in for a tough test here, though, 3rd and long. And that is caught. Touchdown, Washington. Trey Quinn there to make the grab. And the Redskins have taken the lead. There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes
you throw, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man in concert.
Hopkins with the extra point, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. That one in the books as a 12-play drive, and it was polished off by a Redskin touchdown. Touchdown, Dustin Hopkins will kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21-yard line. And you see Dalvin Cook in the offense heading back out. Now he's having himself a little bit of a banner game. His team right now, though, losing.
Needs a little bit of help, and I kind of equate it to a basketball game where you have the big score, and sometimes your strategy is, okay, he can go ahead and have all of his points. Let's hold down everyone else, and that's the way you win the game. And right now, he needs everyone else to start scoring, quote unquote, as he's been.
Yeah, and he's hoping to keep it close so maybe they can keep it on the ground, not start to go through the air as much. They start the drive with Cook. And they'll get eight out of this before being stopped at the 28.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They don't need to run another play here before the two-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. On second down, it's Cook. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. A gain of five, good enough for the first down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Cousins to throw it. It's complete. Abdullah. And he went backwards. He'll be down at the 30. Yikes, a four-yard loss really sets him back now for second down.
That play was well covered. Just tried to check it down. Unfortunately, not able to find any yardage on that one.
Cousins trying to get his guys up to the line of scrimmage quickly.
Kill, turn up.
Draw play, Cousins to Cook. And they see right through that defensively, as he'll be hit and taken down in the backfield. The Redskins now going to use the first of their three timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Another tote for the workhorse this afternoon. It's Cook. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Britton Colquitt now as he's on to punt for Minnesota. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And a nice job here to down this one right on the 5-yard line.
That is how you flip field position. That's an absolute bomb of a punt. Downs it inside the 5-yard line. Absolutely ideal.
From that position, you're hoping to get it down inside the 15, inside the 5. Superb. Now out comes their leader and the captain of this offense back onto the field. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. A carry for the fullback. This is Mike Burton. And he will take this up to about the 8-yard line. Anthony Barr in on the tackle.
A good solid game there on first down, but the defense has to be happy they didn't let it pop for anything bigger.
On second and 7, Haskins slings this deep from McClellan. He's got a man complete. And they finally take him down, but not before he reaches the 43. A big play there just before halftime. 49 yards. The Redskins going to go ahead and use their final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. A 10th carry now for Peterson. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. So we have reached halftime here in a tight 2-point contest.
As we'll send you down to Orlando, and we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everybody, to our abbreviated version of the EA Sports Halftime Report. This game's had a little bit of everything thus far and served out there for the second half. So we'll get right back out there as well, as we'll turn it back over to Brandon Godden.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out come the Vikings. They'll have it first on offense as we begin the third. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess that in the locker room, they talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Cousins and the Vikings with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. Starting the third quarter with Cook. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Second and six, just inside the 30.
Let's go, defense. Hey, man up, D, man up.
Again, it's Cook. It's a six-yard run, leaves him with about a foot or so here still to go to hit the marker with third down coming up.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
Push him back. Push him back.
They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
A lot of different formulas to winning football, but one constant over the years, winning on third down. That pickup there was big because they had struggled throughout this one.
They'll run on first down. Cook. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
That was a really nice play, be able to stack that one up. When they get back in the huddle, he's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a one-yard gain.
53, Mike, 53. Hey, we
got to
get this stop here,
D. On second down now. It's Cook, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down. It's been a remarkable day at the office for him running the football. Those yards just continue to pile well past 100.
And how about more than double-digit carries in the second half alone? That's what you want as a runner, because you've got to prove to your offensive line that you're going to be as tough as they are. They don't rotate in and out on every play. Running backs often do, so those who can stay out there with their offensive linemen, those are the guys they really value.
Here's Madison running on first down. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up eight.
So much of the game today, we're looking for hybrid players, guys who can do a combination of jobs. And anyone who plays a strong safety position, now more than ever, is a hybrid type player. half defensive back that covers passes and half linebacker that makes tackles. We just saw the linebacker make that play.
Give to Cook out of the gun. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He lost four there, and it's third down.
Well, Brandon, he's had a great day, but sometimes the other guys make a play against you. What's that expression they like to use in the NFL? Those guys get paid too, you know.
Yeah, in college they say, hey, they're on scholarship too in the NFL. They're getting paid too. With the day he's had, you can have one go in the wrong direction. Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Play action now. Cousins. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. A minimal gain there on the eighth play of the drive. He steps out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage. Here's Britton Colquitt now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. And look at this, it's a fake. And he won't get there. They stop him a few yards short of the line to gain. A little trickeration there, but it doesn't fool this defense. And the Redskins defense going to take over on the turnover on downs. So here's the Redskins offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Hey, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at their own 43. First play of the drive is a run with Thompson. Eric Kendricks in on the tackle.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
Back to the ground. This time it's Peterson. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
To throw on third down, Haskins, open man, it's Vernon Davis. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. It's a first down for the Redskins on a pickup of 11.
Well, sometimes our pregame meetings do pay off, don't they? What do the guys in the locker room call him?
Well, they said it with a chuckle. They called him old reliable.
Yeah, that means he doesn't move quite as fast as he used to, but he still knows all the tricks, doesn't he? Even that little gentle push off in order to get open, he finds a way to pick up a first down.
First down, it's Haskins, and his throw is incomplete. He's trying to get it to Terry McLaurin, but it's going to be second down. Just a little beyond the reach there of his receiver. That's probably one he wishes he had back.
He wishes it had been 7-on-7 in practice, or maybe even routes versus air, because that's a completion he makes, what, 9.9 times out of 10? Just missed that one.
On second down, Peterson. Give him five on the carry there, and it'll set up a third down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Here's Haskins to throw to Thompson on the screen. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39.
I love the intelligence the defense just showed there. Read their keys, saw the screen developing, ran to it and smothered it. What a third down stop by them.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. This will be from 56 yards out. And this won't get there, won't be online either. It's no good, off to the right, and this score will stay right where it is. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. And we have seen a decline in the numbers. Where does the fault lie? Just him, maybe the guys up front, combination?
Well, as you and I both know, it's almost always a collective deal. But in this case, I think maybe the offensive line got a little overconfident. They had blocked so well in the first half, picked up on what the defense was doing. I think we've seen an adjustment now that they have not picked up on, and now they're being a little bit overwhelmed.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back pocket, don't they?
You have to. And if you don't keep abreast of what you're doing, you lock into a rhythm and make it easy for the opposition.
Looking for tendency breakers right now. And he's got it across the midfield, striping into Washington territory. Calling a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a 3rd and about 4.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice game like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Open man is Thielen. It's complete. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. That his first catch so far. They've held him under wraps, but he's got a first down there. 3rd and 4, he did just enough. I mean, just enough to move the chains.
And that's all you're looking for, right? Just want to keep the drive moving. You don't need the big play there. Just get to that marker that you described, and he was able to do just that.
First down, here's the run with Cook. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. He'll wind up losing a yard on the play, and it'll be 2nd and 11. The run defense, they have been porous at times today, but not that last go around.
No, they really tightened it up, didn't they? They finally got themselves a win because all game long we've seen them get gashed. This time they played their responsibilities, played their keys, and made a nice stop.
They run it again with Cook. He's able to rattle off 6 on the carry, and that'll get him to 3rd and 4.
On a 2nd and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on 3rd down.
Now Cousins. That's caught by Treadwell. And he gets it to the 32, good enough for a 1st down. Cousins able to connect with Treadwell for a Minnesota first.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10.
Let's go, defense. Let's get out the field, defense.
Wait on. Wait on.
They go play action. Cousins. That's complete to the receiver, Thielen. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. It's a gain of 11 as the Vikings pick up the first.
First down. First and 10 at the 21-yard line.
Cousins now pretty remarkable. 14 of 15 through the air, only one incompletion. And another first and 10 here. To throw, Cousins. And Diggs has it. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Back-to-back nice plays. 12 yards that time and a first down. If you're going to blitz, likely going to leave you in man coverage with this guy, and that is less than ideal.
It is, because just about any offense that has an elite receiver, if you blitz and have him in man coverage, you're going to him, even if he has an elite defender on him, because he usually knows where the ball is before the defender does.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
But when you got your backs in the shadow of your goal line, you've got to be physical in that situation, because there's not a whole lot of space, not a lot of wild plays that can be run there.
That's put up or shut up time. Defensively, nice job just to make sure they didn't complete it on that play. Another shot from the 9 on second and goal. A toss to Cook. And a nice pick up there. He gets about 5 down to the 4-yard line.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown, you're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got one, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
Third and goal for Cousins. And that'll be caught by Diggs for a Minnesota touchdown. 4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Vikings are going to retake the lead. That's why you've got your star out there. Throw the ball to him. They did.
That's simply saying, we don't care what coverage you put out there. He's so good, we're going there with the football anyway, and there's not a thing you can do about it.
Inside the red zone, they go to him. He gets it done. Now Bailey to tack on the extra point. And he atones for his miss the first time around as this one is up and good to extend their lead. A pretty long drive that time, 11 plays all told. And it all culminates in a touchdown for Minnesota. Now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's been pretty solid, pretty consistent, just the one touchdown pass, but I think he's managed the game well, no?
I would agree with you, and that's what you're looking for out of your field leader, making sure that you're playing well and not making any big mistakes. Oftentimes, that's how you're judged. Mm-hmm. How big a mistake and when it occurs. No interceptions so far. They'll like that.
I just want you to know that you agreeing with me, that's going to get me through this third and fourth quarter. Are you touched? He's patting his heart, boys and girls. He's touched.
Respect.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A Redskin first down. The pickup, 15 yards.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver, and almost on a direct shot, able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success, as they did on that play.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Shotgun handoff to Thompson. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
The last run got 6, now second and 4.
Defense wins championship, baby.
On second down, here's Haskins. It's caught by Davis. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
Like so many tight ends nowadays, they have no problem at all putting him in the slot and letting him go to work, and that's a nice pitch and catch right there for a first down.
Haskins now, 5 straight completions here in this second half, 1st and 10. Off the play fake, here's Haskins. Completes it to Davis. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to 2nd down.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried the dump off, lost yardage. 2nd and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Now Haskins to throw it over the middle, and it's incomplete. By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. The screen good for 6, but it's not enough as it leads to a 4th down.
Gotta love the catch. I think you gotta love the gloves as well.
Yeah, these one-handed catches, that was great, and they're fun. They're becoming a little more ho-hum, aren't they?
Yeah, they really are. And I know that it sounds like we're taking credit away from the guys, and we don't mean that at all. They really work hard on this one-handed catch thing, but I think the gloves have to be helping in a big way.
Here's Tressway now, as he's on to punt for Washington. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20. And you see Dalvin Cook in the offense heading back out. He's looking sharp here so far in the 3rd quarter, Charles.
It appears that the halftime gave him a little bounce. You know, came out, springing his legs, a little pep in his step, and he's taking off and running really well in the 3rd quarter.
Sometimes we talk about how guys don't want halftime to come, but some guys, they're happy when that break gets there.
You never know which way it's going to go. He's taking advantage of it in this one, though.
Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Here's Cook as they begin on the ground. And he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up 2nd down.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run, just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, you throw it again, then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set him up.
From the 22, here's 2nd and 8.
Rip left, rip left.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Cook. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's 3rd down. 2 yards on the 1st down carry, and then followed up by 2 yards on the 2nd down carry.
Well, that's definitely not going to be enough to get the job done. Wasn't the expression 3 yards in a cloud of dust?
Now they're going to need 6 on 3rd down to keep the drive going. Play fake, Cousins. That one into the hands of Thielen, complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 18 there and give the Vikings a 1st down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on 3rd down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a 1st down.
Now this will probably be the last play of the quarter.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
Good work, boys. And that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. On first down, Cook. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. And I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They'll keep it on the ground. It's Cook. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front 7, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing. Slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
Cousins now to throw on first down. Looking middle, and it's incomplete. Dalvin Cook is running back the intended target, and that'll bring up second down.
The touch and time are critical for those types of throws. He put a lot of zip on that one. Needed just a little bit more finesse trying to get it to his back.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Cousins gives way to Cook. And he picks up about 6 as he gets this down to the 41.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
The old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach? He's in big trouble.
That is not going to be any help as they dump him behind the line of scrimmage. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that's going to make it 4th down.
You know, it's become cliche, but we have seen it and observed it. When runners have days like what we're seeing right now, they often take their offensive linemen out for steaks afterwards, don't they? They'll go buy them dinner. But after a play like that, he might reduce it, might go to the corner and just grab a hot dog or 2, huh?
Hey, I mean, they've still been blocking for him well in this game. They don't get 1 mulligan up front.
Okay, so what we're saying then is we're going petite filet instead of porterhouse.
8 ounces good.
All right, just checking.
So they'll play the field position game here as a very nice punt is going to pin them back.
Yeah, it's almost like watching a game of tennis, or do you prefer ping pong? You know, back and forth like that? That definitely was excellent, wasn't it?
Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. They're going to have to go at least 50, 60 yards here if they want to ensure that they don't have to punt the ball like they did last time.
Yeah, so what you're saying is we're not playing to just get out of the shadow of your own goal line, right? You're playing to make sure the punter doesn't see the field again. So it's not picking up a couple of first downs. You want to pick up 5 or 6 first downs and make sure you move the ball into their territory.
54 miles. And here we go. Watch the pass.
Throwing now, Haskins on first down. Haskins hit and he lost the football. And this will be recovered at least by the offense, but he'll be taken down in the end zone, and that is going to be a safety. Now, the 2 points, that's not totally critical at this point. Still a 1-score game, but they do have to give away the football with no guarantees they're going to get it back.
Yeah, or at least if they get it back, will they have any time to do anything with it? So they've got to send their defense out there and say, guys, we got to have it right now. Save some time for us.
After the safety, remember, they also need to give up the football, and here's the free kick. Taken in at the 11. The Vikings offense now heading out to take over. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Cousins and the Vikings with a 1st and 10 at their own 26.
So don't say nothing.
On the ground, it's Cook. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It was Jonathan Bostic there on the stop.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation. And taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. From the 30 on second down, Cousins. It's complete to Diggs. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. Now the old pass completion for no gain, not something you want to call up out of the playbook too often.
Yeah, most offensive coordinators don't have that on their play sheet, so they've got to go back and scramble after this one. But right now with what they're telling receivers about making sure you take care of the ball in open field, sometimes the fighting for extra yardage doesn't come as a result. That and good tackling can lead to no yards gained.
They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. First down would have been nice, but now you get to kick the field goal, still go up two scores.
They tried to get it though, didn't they? Threw the pass, got the completion just short of the first down, but you're exactly right. Run the field goal unit out there, kick it, put it through the post, go up two scores.
And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Great coverage there, holds him to a two-yard return following a 50-yard punt. And the Washington offense will be backed up to start this drive as they've got it first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 15. Fighting through pressure. And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety. So that a double whammy. Not only do you have to give away the football, but the 2 points, that means this is now a two-score game.
Yeah, and that's tough to deal with, isn't it? This little time left, those 2 points, doesn't seem like a lot, but it means everything now. Those are going to be the ones we're going to look back on. Those 2 points right there, the play of the game.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well, and they free kick it from the 20 now. Returnable for Sherrills.
Let's go! Let's go! Let's go!
And now out comes Minnesota. Now there are two scores on the plus side. Still time here in this fourth quarter, but maybe you start thinking about playing keep away?
Yeah, I think here's the situation. You're not thinking touchdowns anymore. You're just thinking first downs. To keep up with your theme there, playing keep away, first downs, they can't touch the ball.
First down throw for Cousins. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. It was DeShazer Everett that time who got a hand in to break it up.
It's always a battle. Who's going to win on first down, the offense or the defense? Let's face it, if you've got the ball, 4 yards or more on first down is what you're aiming for. They tried to throw for it there. Nice effort to knock that one away and bring up second down.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. From the gun, it's a give to Cook. They only got a couple on that one, so not a ton of help. They'll have a third and 8 forthcoming.
Well, that's a good start to this drive on the defensive side of the ball.
Force the incompletion on first down. Then you're able to shut down the running play on second.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised now. A little bit of pressure going to the quarterback in an expected passing situation.
It's just me and you. It's just me and you.
On third down, Cousins. He completes it to Treadwell. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Give him 18 there and give the Vikings a first down.
And that pickup of a first down, that's going to leave a mark because they really needed to stop them there, didn't they?
So frustrating. Defensively, you're a play away from getting that football back here down late. Tough.
Now they've got to find a way to create a turnover or takeaway. Otherwise, this one will probably get away from them.
check.
The Huck. Ready.
Check. 53. Mike.
Drop deep. Drop deep.
Where's that?
They'll run on first down. It's Cook, and he'll be taken down across the 50 at the 45 in enemy territory. 10 yards, and it's good for a Viking first down.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there, and on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation where they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously, but at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
In Washington territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Here's Cousins. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A very solid gain of 27.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right, because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
Here's a quick throw to Thielen. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect them to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. Now Cook, he's got it off the draw. And always going to be brought down by the face mask. Here come the flags. This is going to get him a first down.
Defense.
They're down here in the fourth, and that personal foul penalty is not going to help.
No, in these types of situations, players will tell you that's extra intensity. From where we sit, it's actually frustration. Not a good play.
So now then, the penalty's got him set up with a first and goal.
36.
Cook following the penalty. And he will fight his way into the end zone for a touchdown. Dalvin Cook, the second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage. And he certainly played a pivotal role with those two TDs and why they're up on the scoreboard right now.
Well, someone's all about winning, aren't they? Because he's not worried about the number. Sure, it's great to have two touchdowns. But the bottom line is what he's doing is contributing to their lead. He wants to continue to do so.
Now Cousins going to bring his guys up for the two-point try. They're going to keep it on the ground. And he gets halfway there down to the 1 yard line.
Well, they couldn't be happy that they were having to stop a 2-point conversion, because that means they gave up a touchdown. But a little solace there. You saw some good gang tackling, stacking him up before he can get to the end zone.
We talk about offensive units putting in more 2-point period sessions in practice. Defensively, do you do the same?
Absolutely. You have to, because you never know how aggressive these offenses are going to be in games nowadays.
Kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Out comes Washington's offense as they get set to take over here. And the last time they had the football, they surrendered 2 points on the safety. They don't want to do that one again.
No, not at all. It's almost like a bases clearing double, isn't it? Give up a couple of runs.
Sure.
just messes things up for you offensively. But now they've got to go ahead, take it, set it aside, and move forward.
Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 28-yard line. On first and 10, it's Haskins. Complete. Richardson has it. At this stage, this drive's got to be touchdown or bust because you need two of them.
And if I'm the offensive play caller, I'm not just looking at my dagger plays downfield. I'm looking at some of my specials, something that can fool them and give you a big play now.
With a sense of urgency.
No doubt.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Looking to throw, Haskins. Got a man, that's Quinn. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44. 7 yards there and a first down. Fourth quarter, every drive so critical, and you figure may only get one more shot after this, so a touchdown's imperative on this drive.
It is, but you also have to think to yourself in play calling, don't hold anything back. Don't save it for the second touchdown. You got the first one for the second one to even matter.
The throw over the middle, taken in. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. They still need about the length of the football here, maybe a little less, as they come up on second and inches. To Thompson on the draw, and he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 2 yards, good enough for a first. Now, yes, a two-possession game, but a good chunk of time on the clock, so they have the ability still there to run it on second and short, but maybe they need to pick it up a bit.
You're right. They did pick up the first down there, but they, as you mentioned, they have to pick up the pace now because it's a two-possession game. They've got to get there twice to make sure they have a chance to win.
On the ground, it's Thompson. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 47. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
I know they've got to be careful not to go to the well too often, but it's a fine line, isn't it? Because sometimes, if you've got success, you want to just keep pounding away.
But no success there. They rallied quickly on the defensive end. Second and 12, Haskins, and incomplete. He was looking for Paul Richardson there, and it's third down.
I think that's a big-time play there because the slant route is really hard to cover because the timing is so quick. But able to see it, diagnose it, and get to the football, that's why he was able to bat it away.
The Redskins on third down. They've converted 7 times and could use another right now. This is third down and 12. Here's Haskins to throw. Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sacked back at about the 43-yard line. Danielle Hunter able to disrupt yet another pass play. That is his third sack of the afternoon.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness of that defensive line is eating them alive.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now it's Haskins, and he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Waynes. There he goes, left side. And he's going to score. It's a Viking touchdown. Will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point try by Bailey. He missed one earlier, remember, but this time he gets it to go. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. This will be taken in at the one. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Redskins offense, they get set to go back to work here. Haskins and the Redskins come up first and 10 at their own 26. Back to the air, Haskins after the pick six. Looking left side and he's got a man. It's Peterson. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It'll wind up being a loss of two. And it'll be second and 12. Second and 12 after the first down pass play went backwards for 2 yards. Now Haskins to throw on second down. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking to get that one to Chris Thompson. And that'll make it third down. At this point, down big, you'd have to imagine this defense are just going to sit back, blanket the field as best they can.
Yeah, this is actually the easy part of the game for them because, just as you noted, they can sit back, keep everything in front of them. But they've blanketed the field the entire game using a variety of coverages.
Third down, here's Haskins. And that is incomplete.
It is tough to complete pass against zone defenses. The windows that you see open, they shrink pretty rapidly. How about being able to hit a moving target against a zone before the next guy can get there and make a play on the ball?
Not easy for any quarterback, no matter the situation. And there, the defense won the battle. Critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. Fourth down, here's Haskins. Catch is made, it's Harmon. And able to rip off a big chunk of yardage before being dropped inside the 40. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Defensively, I know they have the comfortable lead here in the fourth, but they do not want to give up big plays like that.
They want to finish strong. So oftentimes in this situation, you tighten up underneath in your coverage and you bring your safeties back. They can pick up anything that leaks through. But in the meantime, upfield, you're making plays on the football.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Now Haskins on first down, staying on his feet. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes. The sack by big number 98, Linval Joseph.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
Thank you. on some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. From midfield now, Haskins throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. That pass just a little bit off. It looked like maybe he tried to force it in there.
Game speed, always different, no matter what you do in practice. You can't simulate it, right? So your decision making, everything has to be a little bit quicker. Sometimes it can throw you off until you adjust.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now Haskins, third and long. That's going to be caught by Richardson. The completion good for only six, and that'll bring up fourth. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. They're going on fourth down. Haskins, he'll take a shot for the end zone. And this is going to be incomplete. The Redskins go for it, but it doesn't pan out. And the Vikings defense is going to get the football back. Kirk Cousins now gearing up to lead this offense back out there. And those numbers, they kind of tell the story of his game so far. Started off not so hot, now he's really heated up.
And remember, he signed up for duty as the guy who leads the team, right? The field general, the signal caller. So when things go rocky early, he can't just exit out and ask someone else to pick things up. He's got to do it himself, and that's what he's done here in this game.
On first down, Cook. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and eight. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. They'll keep it on the ground. It's Cook. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Vikings in possession of the football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Third down, Dalvin Cook. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a one-yard pickup there, and it'll be fourth down.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat? And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. And the kick's away as he angles this one for the sideline. Out comes the Redskin offense now as they get set to begin another possession. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride?
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, Coach, what do you want to call? He just waved a hand like, who cares? Let's get out of here and do something some other time. But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, probably just want to put this one behind them. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Here's Haskins, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
My good friend, I'm just going to pose the question to you. Did that look like a pass that he should have thrown?
Now, the rookie probably needs to be a little bit more careful in these situations.
Yeah, that throw would turn him into a veteran quicker, but not in the way that he wants. He wants to learn his lessons by making good throws, not throws like that.
Here's second and 10 now from about the 32. Second and 10 now, Haskins. Taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Good job, fellas. Woo! And some secondary help here for the defense in the nickel on third and long.
I got you.
From the gun, Haskins on third down. But he hits the tight end. It's Davis. Now Washington going to use the second of their three timeouts as it comes with a minute four left to go in the game. Here's Tressway now, as he's on to punt for Washington. And that one hits at the seven, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Now the Vikings offense works their way back onto the field. And this one all over but the shouting, you might say. Now there's one timeout remaining defensively, but probably no real need to use it here.
Yeah, the only time they would use it, strictly for pride.
The D can only stop it one more time as they take the knee. On second down, Cook. He is taken down at the 21 after a short gain of two. So the final seconds have ticked away in this Minnesota victory, and they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one, we're thinking to themselves, I bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Vikings as we say so long from Minneapolis.